Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's tutorial is a fishtail style updo. This is similar to tutorials I've done in the past. It was requested from Instagram, however, so I hope you enjoy the video. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. Be sure to subscribe, click that bell, and let's get started. I will be creating this style with a side part on the right side. You can place the part wherever you'd normally like. Then I'm going to divide my hair into two sections. So I'm continuing the part down the center of the back of my head to split all of my hair into a left and a right side. Now I'm going to pick up a section of hair on the left side of my head near the part line and divide it into three sections to begin my braid. I'm crossing one side over the middle, then crossing the other side over the middle, and then I'm going to combine the middle and the back strand together. So now I have two sections for my braid. I'm creating a fishtail braid, so I'm taking a small section of hair from one side, crossing it over and adding it into the opposite side. I'm also picking up a new section of hair from my head and crossing it over as well, adding it into the other strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the front strand and crossing it over to the back strand, picking up a new section of hair from along the hairline, crossing it over and adding it into the back strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the back strand and crossing it over to the front strand. Then I'm picking up a new section of hair from along my head, crossing it over and adding it into the front strand as well. I'm going to continue this pattern, creating the fishtail style French braid and braiding the hair on the left side of my head along the hairline until it reaches down near my left ear. So I'm taking a small section of hair from one side, crossing it over and adding it into the opposite side. I'm also picking up a new section of hair from my head and crossing it over as well, adding it into the other strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the back strand and crossing it over to the front strand. Then I'm picking up a new section of hair from along my head, crossing it over and adding it into the front strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the front strand and crossing it over to the back strand, picking up a new section of hair from along the hairline, crossing it over and adding it into the back strand as well. I'm going to continue this pattern, creating the fishtail style French braid and braiding the hair on the left side of my head along the hairline. Once the braid reaches around towards the back of my head and I've brought in hair from behind my ear, I'm going to continue braiding the section a little further down and then slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid to work with later. Now I'm going to create another fishtail braid on the right side of my head using the hair on this side. I'm picking up a small section near the part line and dividing it into three equal pieces. I'm crossing one side over the middle, then crossing the other side over the middle, and then I'm going to combine the middle and the back strand together. So now I have two sections for my braid. I'm creating a fishtail braid, so I'm taking a small section of hair from one side, crossing it over and adding it into the opposite side. I'm also picking up a new section of hair from my head and crossing it over as well, adding it into the other strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the front strand and crossing it over to the back strand, picking up a new section of hair from along the hairline, crossing it over and adding it into the back strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the back strand and crossing it over to the front strand. Then I'm picking up a new section of hair from along my head, crossing it over and adding it into the front strand as well. I'm going to continue this pattern,
creating the fishtail style French braid and braiding the hair along the hairline until it reaches down near my left ear. So I'm taking a small section of hair from one side, crossing it over and adding it into the opposite side. I'm also picking up a new section of hair from my head and crossing it over as well, adding it into the other strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the back strand and crossing it over to the front strand. Then I'm picking up a new section of hair from along my head, crossing it over and adding it into the front strand as well. I'm taking a small section from the front strand and crossing it over to the back strand, picking up a new section of hair from along the hairline, crossing it over and adding it into the back strand as well. I'm going to continue this pattern, creating the fishtail style French braid and braiding the hair along the hairline. Once the braid reaches around towards the back of my head and I've brought in hair from behind my ear, I'm going to continue braiding the section a little further down and then slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid to work with later. Once I've braided both sides of my head into fishtail braids, I'm going to create the bun portion of the hairstyle. I'm going to combine all of my hair together, including the ends of the braids, and I'm going to tie it into a low ponytail near the nape of my neck. I'm going to remove the bobby pins from the ends of the braids and combine all of the hair together, twisting it into one section. Then I'm going to wrap it clockwise around the hairband. I'm laying the ends over the center of the bun and then pinning the bun in place using bobby pins. I placed a pin into the bun wherever I was holding it with my hands or anywhere that it felt as though the bun was a little bit loose. And I just like to grab onto a little bit of hair from the bun and then angle the pin into the bun towards the center. This way the pin will slide into the hair and not stick out and show when the style is finished. Then I'm going to wrap the ends over the top of the bun and around the right side before pinning the hair against my head using more bobby pins. I take a bit of hair from the bun and then push the pin against my head underneath the bun to hold it in place. This hides the pins underneath the hair. You really can create any type of bun that you prefer for this style. I wanted to try something that was a little bit more smooth and sleek.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know what you think down below in the comments section. Be sure to subscribe if you're new. Click that bell, then you'll never miss any future videos. And I will see you next time.